Once upon a time, there was an orchestra, which was all busy tuning up. First, the oboe gave his aid to the strings, then to the woodwinds, and to the brass. Up and around the scales, they raced helter-skelter, faster and faster. All but Tubby the Tuba. He was a fat little tuba, puffing away, but oh, so slow.
Oh, what lovely music, thought Tubby, and he sighed.
Here, what's the matter, said Peepo the Piccolo.
Oh, said Tubby, every time we do a new piece, you all get such pretty melodies to play. And I never, never a pretty melody.
But people never write pretty melodies for tubas. It just isn't done.
Shh, there's the conductor. First the violins dance their lovely little tune on their strings. Then they cry to the flute, catch!
Got it, cried the flute.
My turn, tooted the trumpet. And the rest joined in. The cello. Then the oboe. And the bassoon. While Tubby went pop, 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 pop.
Catch me, cried the little tune, catch me.
I got you, cried Tubby.
Oh, you're sitting on me, said the little tune.
Poor Tubby picked up the flat little tune and tried to squeeze it back into shape. You clumsy fool, snapped the violins.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fiddle, said Tubby.
Fiddle? Fiddle indeed! And the violins quivered with great indignation. You will please address us as violins. Fiddles indeed! Tubby, said the conductor. Tubby, what is the matter?
Please, sir, I thought it would be so nice to dance with a pretty little tune instead of just going oompa oompa all the time.
Dance, laughed the violins. Dance? Well, really. The French horn quietly put his hand to his mouth and smiled, and the whole orchestra began to laugh. Stop it, cried the conductor. Stop it, I say. Tubby.
Please, sir, I wasn't laughing.
Rehearsal was over. Tubby was walking home with Peepo the Piccolo.
Please, Peepo, said Tubby. I just feel so bad. I don't think I want any company.
I understand, said Peepo. Good night.
Good night, said Tubby.
The moon was out, and Tubby went to the river and sat on a log, and he looked at himself in the water.
Alone am I, me and I together. If I went away from me, how unhappy I would be. Me and I, oh my.
The trees whispered in the wind, and the waterfalls tinkled. Suddenly, a big bullfrog hopped out of the water and sat down on a log beside him. Lovely evening.
I said, lovely evening. I said, beautiful evening.
Hello, hello,
hello.
But Tubby just sat.
Oh, well, said the frog. Oh, well, if I'm not wanted.
Oh, cried Tubby, please, Mr. Frog, come back. I didn't mean to be impolite.
Back hopped the frog.
Oh, that's all right. I'm used to it. No one pays any attention to me either.
Really? Said Tubby.
Why, of course. Every night I sit here and sing my heart out. But does anyone listen?
No. Can you sing? Asked Tubby.
Can I sing? Listen.
Oh, that's lovely, said Tubby.
You try it, said the frog.
Oh, thank you, said Tubby.
Say, you're a very fine tuba, do you know it? Tubby, you should try that on your orchestra sometime.
Oh, I will, said Tubby. Goodbye, Mr. Frog. And off went Tubby, as happy could be.
Said the frog. Most appreciative audience I've ever had. Fine musician, that tuba. Good night.
The next day, the orchestra was busy tuning up for the rehearsal and buzzing with excitement over the arrival of the great new conductor, Signor Pizzicato. Here he comes, called the French horn. Here comes Signor Pizzicato.
All right, gentlemen, let us begin.
And Tubby began to play his own little melody.
Oh, that wretched tuba snapped the violins. He'll disgrace us. The trombone stuck out his tongue. And the trumpet snickered.
Tubby, said Signor Pizzicato. Tubby, I've never heard a tuba play a melody before. Would you play the rest of it?
Oh, said Tubby.
Why, how perfectly wonderful, said the strings. Please, Tubby, may we sing your tune, too? How about me, said the xylophone. And me, said the trombone. May I, said the celeste.
Here I come, said Peepo.
And they all play.
We've done it, haven't we, Tubby?
It was the bullfrog sitting right beside him.
Oh, thought Tubby, how happy I am.
Everybody said it was spring. But Tubby didn't think so. Tubby was a fat little tuba. He umpahed when he walked. He umpahed when he talked. And when he sighed, it was the saddest umpah you ever heard. Cheer up, Tubby. Spring is here.
Oh, no, it isn't, said Tubby. When the buds begin to pop and the robin takes a hop, everybody says it's spring today. I suppose that may be so, but I'd like for you to know I can always tell it's spring another way. I can always tell it's spring when the circus comes to town. It makes me want to sing when I bump into a clown. When the circus marches past and the band goes tantara, I know it's spring at last and my heart goes oompa.
Oompa, 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 oompa.
You hear that, right, Tubby? Here comes the circus. Now I know it's spring.
Suddenly, a happy little idea started buzzing around Tubby's head.
Bzzz. Tubby, why should you have to wait for the circus every year? Why don't you join the circus? Then you'd be with it all the time.
But what would I do, said Tubby? I'm not very talented.
Why, that's easy, Tubby. You could be a bareback rider. Or a lion tamer. A clown. A juggler. An acrobat. You could be anything your heart desires.
Oh, my, said Tubby. You're the most wonderful idea I've ever had. Let's go and tell Senor Pepperino right now.
Senor Pepperino, the great ringmaster, twirled his mustachios.
So, my fat little friend, you would like to join the circus? That's very interesting. I have just the job for you. My elephants are always very thirsty. Your job will be to make sure they have enough water to drink.
Tubby picked up two buckets of water.
I guess this is better than nothing. At least I'm in the circus now. Do you know how many buckets of water it takes to fill an empty elephant? Oh, more than that. Lots more.
Poor, tired Tubby.
Well now, said a kindly old elephant, I think we've had enough to drink, at least for now. The circus is about to start. Why don't you take a peek? You deserve it.
Tubby peeked. There stood Senor Pepperino, twirling his mustachios and flicking his whip.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please!
It was the most wonderful circus Tubby had ever seen. The clowns went hippity, 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 hippity hop. The horses went clippity, 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 clop. And high up in the air, the acrobats went flippity flop. And then Tubby saw his little idea swinging on a trapeze and singing away. Alley-oop, oom-pa, alley-oop, oom-pa, an acrobat you ought to be. Alley-oop, oom-pa, alley-oop, oom-pa. Hey, Tubby, you'd be a sight to see.
Well then, shouted Tubby, what am I waiting for? Alley-oop I go, and up to the top of the tent went Tubby.
There was Tubby way up on top of the tent. And then Tubby's idea said,
all right, Tubby, let's see you walk that tightrope. Use your buckets of water to balance you. Easy, Tubby, easy. Be careful. Watch it, Tubby!
Down came the buckets. Down came Tubby, right on top of Senor Pepperino.
Oh, cried Senor Pepperino, wringing his drooping mustachios. You have ruined me. Back to the elephants with you.
Tubby curled up in a pile of straw, and the tears dropped one by one.
Cheer up, Tubby, said the kindly old elephant. Things aren't that bad, you know. You just tried to be the wrong thing, that's all. What would you say if I told you a very long time ago I wanted to be a toe dancer?
Tubby smiled.
That's better, said the elephant. Now you listen to me. Be yourself. You can't be anybody else. Be yourself is my advice to you, or else you'll always be a nobody. So be yourself or else. A
hippopotamus would look very curious, flying like a butterfly. A fierce and hungry lion would look very silly trying to bake an apple pie. I think you'd get a laugh if you saw a tall giraffe swinging by his tail from a tree. I think an octopus would look quite ridiculous knitting sweaters at the bottom of the sea. So be yourself and do the things that you know best. Be yourself. I think that you'd be happiest by being no one else but you.
That's all very well, said Tubby, but the only thing I do best is oompa.
Well, said the elephant, let's hear it. There must be something we can do with an oompa.
Tubby began to sing his oompa. And before he knew it, all the elephants were standing in a circle around him, their trunks swaying to the music.
Why, said the kindly old elephant, I believe that oompa just makes me want to dance.
And he and the other elephants got up on their hind legs and started to waltz. Suddenly, Senor Pepperino walked in.
Why, what is this? Never have I seen the elephants dance so beautifully. What has happened?
The kindly elephant pointed to Tubby, oompaing away with a happy smile on his face.
Oh, said Senor Pepperino, remarkable, sensational. Tubby, I have a wonderful idea. How would you and your oh-so-graceful elephants like to be the main attraction of our circus? Ladies and gentlemen, I have the great honor to present Senor Tubby and his magnificent oompa with his dancing elephants.
How Tubby played and how the elephants danced.
And now, shouted Senor Pepperino, the grand finale. Let the whole circus dance. Play, Tubby, as you never have played before.
Oh, thought Tubby, I wouldn't change places with anyone in the whole world. And hullabaloo, alakazam, and he comes to you. Uncle Pockets, Uncle Pockets, with his magic pockets. Hoop-dee-doo and hullabaloo, alakazam, and he finds for you mops and tops and lollipops, also a canoe, which could be worn as a shoe.
A shoe!
Could be worn as a shoe. And the most amazing thing about the pockets where he's got them, they all have tops, but they don't seem to have any bottom. So hoop-dee-doo and hullabaloo, alakazam, and it's true. From a supersonic motor to a double chocolate soda, there's nothing Uncle Pockets hasn't got. Also a yacht, nothing Uncle Pockets hasn't got. Got a scooter full of chrome work, a brush to make your comb work, a magic pencil that will do your homework, and balls if you can bat 'em, a cat that eats macadam, an atomizer if you find an atom, a telephone to chat on, a mat to put your cat on, a frying pan that has a cowboy hat on, which when you come to think of it, isn't very strange, for a pot should be at home on the range.
Oh, now we know on whom to depend for rockets and sockets and sprockets.
You do? On who?
On whom?
All right, on whom and you may depend.
On the men with the pockets and pockets and pockets and pockets and pockets and pockets. Whoop-dee-doo and hullabaloo. Alakazam and he comes to you.
Uncle Pockets with his magic pockets.
Whoop-dee-doo and hullabaloo. Alakazam and he finds for you.
Mops and tops and lollipops, also a canoe. Which could be worn as a shoe.
A shoe!
Could be worn as a shoe.
And the most amazing thing about the pockets where he's got them, they all have tops.
But they don't seem to have any bottom.
So hoop-dee-doo and hullabaloo, Alakazam, and it's true. From a supersonic motor to a double chocolate soda, there's nothing Uncle Pockets hasn't got.
Also a yacht.
Nothing Uncle Pockets hasn't got. No matter what, no matter what, no matter what, no matter what.
No matter what.
Who knows a game?
I know a game. Listen to it carefully and follow after me. There's a hole in the bottom of the sea. There's a hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a hole, there's a hole. There's a hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a log, there's a log.
There's a log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea. There's a branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a branch, there's a branch. There's a branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a bump, there's a bump.
There's a bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea. There's a frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a frog, there's a frog. There's a frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a tail, there's a tail.
There's a tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a speck on the tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea. There's a speck on the tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a speck, there's a speck. There's a speck on the tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a fleck on the speck on the tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
There's a what?
Like I said.
In the bottom of the sea.
There's a fleck, there's a fleck.
There's a fleck on the speck on the tail on the frog on the bump on the branch on the log in the hole in the bottom of the sea.
So let's flick the fleck, brush the speck, twist the tail, chase the frog, flatten the bump, break the branch, burn the log, fill the hole.
Hole in the bottom of the sea. Cause we need it like a hole in the sea. In the sea. In the sea.
Sea.